tell by the look on my boss's face. He got too drunk the night before to show his ass. It's the eyes. The red film that covers Emily's particular morning speaks of violence and vulgarity directed at his living girlfriend. An elderly woman widowed 10 years ago who took up residence in the town of Lowell and was in a sense of charity. The booze had him long before her. I'm gonna go ahead and say there's no help for him. He's a thick guy whose head sits directly on top of his shoulders. He wears camouflage, white t-shirts, and effort to express his masculinity. But I've gone astray. His eyes, backward eyes, man. On average mornings, they range from moderately dilated to noticeably glazed. But after a night of particularly drawn out vices and aforementioned red film occasions, his eyes are just blinking and fearful. It makes me afraid to let him drive the golf cart because he's too focused on what he can't remember and pay attention to all kinds of traffic. We've yet to tumble down into bed. I said, woman, if you're going to waste $3 on a 30-cent pot pie, then you can go ahead and get the fuck out of my house. That's what I said. And I've been thinking, I ain't getting married again. I told him I thought it was a little extreme to break off his engagement over something as inconsequential as her distaste for microwave dinners. But he shrugged it off and told me to keep my eyes open for garbage.